pretty good for Richard. It's important that the rock not be seen. Just rock.
Oh, hi. It's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.net. Yes, after hard days of gardening and just getting all tired and sweaty, I am now luxuriating in a beautiful little cottage at San Ysidro Ranch in Southern California. Well, we have our own little bed with mosquito netting.
Canopy.
Orange juice at bedside, coffee perking over in the corner. And we are about to explore the grounds here at the ranch and see what kind of gardening goes on here in Southern California. So far we've seen avocado trees. We've eaten grapefruit off of a grapefruit tree. We've eaten mandarin oranges off of the tree. Picked some avocados. There were peaches and cherries. And we're now headed toward grape country. So we're looking forward to going into a vineyard and actually seeing grapes growing on established vines and asking questions. How do we get our grapes to grow like this, even though they're in a different climate? So we've been told that there are beautiful pathways to climb, not up into the mountains, but there are mountains here that you just look at and they're just fabulous. One day they're foreboding and gray and shrouded, and yesterday they were just green and you could see every tree outlined against the horizon. It was gorgeous. So I suppose I should get up and start my daily routines in a whole new place. Wait till you see what I am going to get to see and do. So here I am in my robe. Let me peek out and see what the weather's like. Oh, it's partly sunny. I think I'll go. Oh, there's my hot tub. Maybe I should go in there. Ah, yes, it's a hard life, but someone has to live it. So here I sit, lounging again. Never did make it to the hot tub yet because I got sidetracked by coffee and flowers. Never have this in Wisconsin in the morning. When we left Wisconsin a few days ago, it was snowing. And here we are in California. I'm out here in my little robe, waiting to jump in the hot tub. And then after that, maybe an outdoor shower. It's just gorgeous. Many fine restaurants grow their own herbs and vegetables, and San Ysidro Ranch is one of them. You can see in the background they have their own lemon trees that they just go pick lemons off of, and oranges, and fig trees you see growing here. And then you look down into the beds and they have chives and onions and dill and parsley and thyme, different kinds of lettuce. They're growing their beans. They're just starting now. They have Swiss chard of the multicolored variety, so when they put it in the salad, it looks beautiful. They have nasturtiums, which are edible. You see the little orange flower there. I'm not sure what that is, but here's some more thyme, sage, probably garlics, fennel,
leeks, Green
and you
greens.
See in the background there, the purple, that's lavender. And all over the compound, you will find little sprigs of lavender as decoration on your towel, on your bed, everywhere. We've got cabbages. Did I say that? These look like some kind of squash. Either they're going to be zucchinis or maybe cucumbers. But it's just, it's the thing good restaurants do, and more are doing it. It even looks like they have a hedge over there that has either rosemary or thyme or some kind. Oh, grapefruits. I think I see grapefruits, perhaps. So it's just, well, it's beautiful, it smells good, and it's just lovely to look at.
And I think, you know, traveling like this allows you to get new ideas.
Well, sure. Because you think, well, I could grow those herbs in my garden, even if it's in just a little pot. You know, and then in the upper climates, obviously, you either take the pot in with you or you leave it out and just start all over the next year. Some things last in our climate. They're hardy, but unfortunately not lemons or oranges or avocado trees. But we have many things we could grow, but nothing like this. I mean, you look at the at that one little home, and just look at all of the flowers blooming all over it. It's lovely.
Yep, these have great little cottages. I think they said there's, what, 30-some cottages on a 500-acre landscape owned by Ty Warner,
right,
who has some great hotels and restaurants all around the country.
The originator of Beanie Babies.
Yes.
Bye for now. I'm going exploring.